It's fantastic to have you here with us at the Entertainment Media Show. Have you been enjoying meeting fans today?
Oh, it's been fantastic, Russell. I just love it. I'm thrilled to be in the UK, and everybody's been really sweet. We've had great lines, a great crowd. I understand tomorrow's going to be just over the top. So it's been a blast. It's really nice.
I mean, I understand you've been receiving some gifts from fans. What kind of stuff have they been giving you?
Oh, I get the wildest thing. You know, I have a huge, huge Facebook fan base, and a lot in the UK, and it was my birthday, so I got these beautiful cupcakes, pornographic cupcakes that were very nice, and I got a beautiful birthday card from a five-year-old, and books, and you know, people bring me dolls and just all kinds of things, you know, t-shirts, and of course they bring me money, which is always very nice too.
Clearly fans want to give something back to you. Why do you think they love this franchise so much? Why do you think these films mean so much to so many different people?
We've had a lot of time to think about the franchise over the course of the year. And I don't know why it resounds with people so much. I know why mine does. I mean, the part two has a very specific take, and it has very specific fans who are very dedicated. And my fans, on my Facebook, I think I have 10,000, 12,000 people. And we actually write to each other. I mean, I know these people, and they just love Nightmare on Elm Street. The fans are anywhere from 70 to 10 years old. It just never stops, you know? So it's a pretty constant thing. And the stories are good, you know? I think, especially the first three, I think are very scary movies, but they have good heroes and heroines in them, and people identify with it.
You mentioned there the franchise has obviously evolved so much over time. What do you think it was specifically about the second installment that made it just resound so strongly with certain fans?
Oh, it definitely is the gay element to it. And that's what made it so sort of disliked in the beginning. And over the course of 25 years, it's what it sort of became known for. I was playing a girl's part. I mean, it was usually the protagonist in one of these movies is a girl, a blonde girl. And instead it was a boy. And if you notice in Nightmare on Elm Street, my Nightmare on Elm Street, Freddy's always mean to girls, but to me, he's very sweet. He, like, in this scene right here, he's caressing me and pulling my hair back, and he only boys die in mine. He kills every boy who's nice to me. And so that, you know, pushed a few buttons in people. and that's a lot of the conversation around Nightmare on Elm Street is that, on this Nightmare on Elm Street too. But what's happened over the last few years is, like, major critics have gone back and changed their reviews of Nightmare on Elm Street. Like Rotten Tomatoes used to have a horrible review of Nightmare on Elm Street 2, and now it's 4 stars and it's the best one on there. So it's just time, you know. People look at them differently when they're, say, 13 years old, and then they see them again when they're 30. It's a completely different movie.
Clearly there's an age range in the fans that you get. What's the youngest and the oldest fan you've met in general, but or specifically here?
Today the youngest was 5, and Kim and I always laugh because she's a mother, and she'll always say, like, oh, you know, don't you like Barney, or don't you like, you know, somebody? No, I love Freddy. And my oldest fan today was probably in his 70s or 75, something like that. But I mean, on the Facebook, I have people that are, I ain't old, 85, 90 years. And I have fans from every continent, and now China has just started rolling in. So, I mean, literally from all over the world, just everywhere in the world. So, I don't know, I think everybody knows. I take this through customs, my glove through customs, and it has a picture with it, and I've never been, as a carry-on, I've never been turned down on a plane. And usually the people want a signature. And they're like, oh my God, Freddie. And, you know, try to take this on a plane. I dare you to try to, you know what I mean? It's just because it really will cut you. So just everybody in the world knows Freddy Krueger, you know?
He is one of the most iconic characters in modern cinema. What do you think it is about Freddy? I mean, even within the kind of horror movie monsters, he seems to stand and sort of tower above a lot of the others. Why is that?
I think most people have night terrors, of course, and it's the fact that he could take over your dream world. And I think a lot of it, you know, quite honestly, has to do with Robert Englund. I know a lot of people don't know Robert's other work from before, but Robert has always been an amazing character actor. And, you know, in the beginning of Nightmare on Elm Street 2, they thought they could just use anybody, like they did in the Jason. You know, there were six different Jasons. And so they thought, we'll just get a guy, put a mask on him, and that'll be that. And, of course, within 2 days, they realized they'd made a horrible mistake. Because his personality comes through, you know, and he is the quintessential first or second scariest horror person of the century, really. And I mean, it's a worldwide franchise that they don't believe will end for another 3 or 4 generations. So I don't know. It's just in the zeitgeist. It just was something that happened.
Clearly, the legacy of the early films continues to grow. I mean, have you been following the franchise? Have you watched the recent sort of rebirth? And how do you feel about all of that?
Well, because of the fans that we have, it's brought up a lot. And I think Warner Brothers owns Nightmare on Elm Street now. And I think they made a tremendous mistake. And the mistake they made was not Jackie, because we all like Jackie. We know Jackie. But they never contacted Robert, and they never contacted Heather. And if they would have been very smart, they would have called them up and said, hey, what do you think? Can you help us out a little bit? Would you go on tour and say something nice about it? But they didn't even bother to say hello to them until the movie came out. And the hardcore fan base turned on them quickly. The movie didn't have a chance from the beginning because the bloggers were just like, they were so offended for Robert. So, but I always say that, Nightmare on Elm Street for me will always be our nightmare. I mean, this is our family. I mean, we've all grown up together, you know. So Tuesday's a friend, Lisa's a friend, Heather's a friend, Kim is certainly a dear friend, Robert. We're all, you know, we're like sort of bonded together. And that'll always be Nightmare on Elm Street for me. And the new one is for a new generation of people. It's for young people who, that'll be their first experience. Although I don't think we'll see another Nightmare on Elm Street. So I think it's done now.
Clearly you've developed these wonderful friendships on set. I guess looking back to that experience, are there any particular moments on set, any particular memories you have that just always make you smile, that you hold fond?
Oh, sure. Oh, absolutely. I have. Well, I was very dear friends with the woman who played my mother, Hope Lang, and we got drunk one afternoon. By accident. Well, she got drunk a lot of days, but she insisted I have a couple of martinis with her, and that was a really fun day. And I just, you know, actually every day was kind of fun. It was the first time that I was a star of a movie. I'd been in many movies before, but it's really exceptional to be the star of a movie. I mean, you're treated like a god, like a king. And it's like coming to these conventions. I mean, I don't really know how anybody could feel bad. You know, people come and talk to you. They're very nice to you. They pay for your autograph. And then they say thank you. And if you can find something wrong with that, then you need to have another life completely. So making movies is a lot of fun. And getting to be a movie star, and even just one, is like a dream come true. Because I think everybody would like to do that, you know, at least one time. So I think that's my general memories of it. The opening night in New York City, the movie sold out in every theater by 10 o'clock. And there were 10,000 people in line when Robert and I went in. And we went in and nobody knew who we were. And when we came out, we were movie stars in that moment. I think that was pretty significant, yeah.
Extraordinary experience, and it's been a wonderful pleasure to talk to you today. I'm going to let you go, but the last question, for any fans who couldn't be here, for all of those Nightmare fans out there watching this, is there anything you'd like to say to them?
Well, I'd like to say to them, we'll just thank you, and I'm sorry you didn't get to make it. Maybe you'll see us someplace else. And come and visit, if you really love Nightmare on Elm Street, come to my Facebook page, Mark Patton. And if you can't get on that one, then come to Mark Patton, The Real Me. And we have a great community of people there. And the fans are really, I'm here because one fan just got tired of me not being in the UK. And these people, needful things, like they just said, okay, we're paying for it. And then the convention stepped in and said, oh no, we'll sponsor him. And I'm going to Australia, I'm going to Tokyo. And so I'm sure by the time this gets to you, I will have been to your town. So, but just come and say hi, because we really do have a good time.